experience, but at the same time, I was blocking what had happened to me until my spiritual father told me I need to tell my story, but he had no clue what the story was.
But nowadays, we have to take the conversation even further to say, how old should you be before you stop sitting on somebody's lap? How safe is it to go in the bathroom with even another kid?
Because I remember a situation, it wasn't so much about abuse as far as touching, but it was verbal abuse.
Mm-hmm. For God, submission to her is that abuse doesn't always come with a touch.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So it's the grooming part of it that I omitted, that I've had to visit with her here recently, just having these conversations in light of all the sex trafficking that's happening.
I had to rethink that and say, whoa, I have to reassure her mm-hmm. that I'm still, and I tell her I don't care who it is. It could be my mom, it could be my dad, because mm-hmm. I was abused in the family. So it's like, I don't care who it is, right. You come and tell me.
Right.
You really have to find your place. And this is a hard place.
When is the last time you, as a survivor, sat and talked about sex?
Right. So that's what ends up happening, but you get a couple of generations down and nobody knows, why are the kids not going around with a gun? That's where the quietness, that's where we get into trouble with them.
So I never dealt with depression and suicide like then, having conversations with suicide.
And it took literally being to almost saying, God, if you take me today, I'm good. Not that I'm going to take my own life, but that I got so fed up by the age of 36 that, okay, something got to give.